Our question for today came from Bart. Dear Jonah, one advice I hear from successful freelance writers is to find a niche. How do I decide what specialization I'll choose? And they say content writing pays less than copywriting or creating sales materials. But I think it's easy for me to write content like blog articles as a beginner. What do you think? Thank you for asking that question, Bart, because I receive a lot of similar inquiries. There are 5 things I want you to consider when choosing your niche or specialization mo. First is the subject. Maybe you have topics that you're comfortable writing about because you're knowledgeable in that area. For example, if you're a health practitioner, you can definitely write about topics pertaining to the subject. Or for example, interest mo talaga yung food and travel. So writing articles about that would be easy, I agree, than learning something new. Second would be your target market. So after focusing on the topic, pwede kang mag-isip sino yung mga prospect clients na naghahanap ng ganung articles, ng ganung services. Who are the clients who would need to write about food or recipes or about health? Pwede mong tingnan would be coaches, people who owns blogs or e-commerce websites na kailangan ng ganung articles to drive traffic to their web pages. So if you find that there are a lot of people, communities sa Facebook, or maybe merong mga ganong profile of entrepreneurs or marketers sa LinkedIn, then that means merong demand for that kind of service. If you also go through freelancing sites, you can check ano ba yung mga topics na hinahanap nila, na gusto nilang magsulat ka about. Because most of the parang mistakes I see is you want to focus on a specific topic, let's say history, pero wala namang malaking demand for that. You have to balance what you know or what you want to offer with what's being in demand in the market. Third thing that I want you to consider would be time. How much time are you willing to spend in freelance writing? Because there are projects or specializations that would take longer time to finish. For example, kung ang isa-specialize mo, ebooks, training manuals, mga long-form content, this would take more than 2 or 3 days to finish. And kung wala kang ganung capacity in a week because you have a full-time job, then you might want to consider kung ano yung feasible and manageable sa time mo. Next one is yung pay. Tama ka. Yung different forms of content that you create, iba-iba rin yung katumbas na payment for the services that you provide. So when you said and want to confirm copywriting, ang goal ng copywriting is to sell products and services. So definitely, people will pay higher for those kinds of services. But it's something that you have to learn as well. Kasi may certain skill sets ang copywriters na pwedeng wala ang content writers and you have to develop it. So after yung money or how much you'll earn from it, last thing that I want you to consider is yung magiging scope of work. Kasi writing, sometimes when people would say, I need a writer, they won't think na I need someone to research as well. I need someone to edit as well. I need someone to proofread. So, merong mga packages or services na all-in na. Pero meron din naman na ang kailangan lang nila, someone who will write, meron na silang provided outline or ni-research. So, pwedeng maging specialization mo rin yung any of those. Like, let's say you have experience in editing or proofreading, and mas manageable yun for your time. Then, baka gusto mong consider maging freelance editor na lang. Or maybe part of the requirement when you offer your service is that if you want your clients to pay lower, meron na silang ibibigay sa'yo na research or outline para at least yung magiging project ninyo, yung deal na maka-close ninyo would be something na you're sure you can deliver. Kasi I just want you to think ahead. I know you're thinking of what to specialize on, but parang thinking ahead, I want you to consider din paano mo madedeliver yung project na yon, yung written output na yon, since you chose na ito yung gagawin mong service. So I hope that my tips were able to help you, Bart. And if you're an aspiring freelance writer like Bart, we have resources in Writing Hacks Academy that can help you. I invite you to download our ebook, How to Earn Extra Income as a Freelance Writer. Libre ito. And we also have an upcoming talk about freelance writing roadmap. So that's where I'll share my tips and specific action plan on how you can get started as a freelance writer. Thank you for watching this video, and do check out those resources.